Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate you how you can create objects in Salesforce. So before starting, you can also see how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name and my channel will be there. So you can use this channel to learn programming. Moving back, so I'm clicking on login so that I can enter into Salesforce org. So I hope you know what objects are in Salesforce. So objects are basically a collection of records where we can store information related to a particular entity. So now we are going to learn how we can create objects in Salesforce. So we need to click on setup. So in my previous video, I demonstrated you like whatever you want to do in Salesforce, you need to use this setup. So if you want to create new object, you can just search object. The option create object will be available here. So you need to click on this objects. Here you can see it is showing the option new custom object. So basically in Salesforce, we have two types of objects. One is standard and one is custom. So standard objects are those which are default provided by Salesforce, and custom we need to create at our own. So the standard ones are account, contact, opportunity, lead, etc. But if you want any object other than that, then you can create your own, right? So here you can read this statement. Custom objects are database tables that allow you to store data specific to your organization in Salesforce. You can use custom objects to extend Salesforce functionality or to build new application functionality, right? Then it says, once you have created a custom object, you can create a custom tab, custom related lists, reports, and dashboards for users to interact with the custom object data. You can also access custom objects data through the API, right? So now we are going to create new custom object. So here we need to fill some information so that we can create new custom object. So first of all, I have to enter the label. So suppose I want to store information related to students. So my object name will be student. Then it is saying plural label. So plural label is students. So this plural label is used for tab purpose. So on the top, you can see these are all tabs, campaigns, leads, accounts, contacts, opportunities, and so on. So this plural label is used for that purpose. Then you need to click on this checkbox if your label starts with vowel sound. So student is not starting with vowel sound, so I'm leaving it as unchecked. Then the object name is used when referencing the object via the API. So this is the unique name of this object. We can use this unique name while implementing this object with the help of code, right? Then you can write any description here. So in real-time scenarios, while you will be working in projects for any company, so you need to write proper descriptions here so that any other developer can understand why this object is created. So this will store information related to students in the university. Right, so this way you can provide any description. Now we have another option, context sensitive help setting. So it has two options, open the standard salesforce.com help and training window, open a window using a Visual Force page. So I'm choosing first option only, like we want to open the standard salesforce.com help and training window if we want to take any help related to this object. Then we have next option, enter record name, label, or format. So we have two data types here, text and number. So We have unique label for each record that will be created under this object. So we can either choose text or we can choose auto number. So if you read this description here, the record name appears in page layouts, key list, related list, lookups, and search results. So these names you will get to know, like what is page layout, key list, related list in further videos, because this is the beginning. So you might not be understanding what are these, but through this example, you can understand what is the record name, label, and format. So for example, the record name for account is account name, and for case, it is case number. So for account, if you want to use account name, then you need to choose data type as text. Then for case, if you want to choose case number, then you can choose auto number. So it is saying that for account number, we can prefer name, and for case, we can prefer case number. So as per your requirement, like for record, which label you want to prefer, text or number, you can choose. Further, it says, note that the record name field is always called name when referenced via the API. So its name will be always, its unique name will be always name, whether you select text or number. So right now I'm selecting text, and its label will be student name, and its unique name will be name, right? Then it has optional features, allow reports, allow activities, track field history, allow in chatter groups. So these are optional features. So we will discuss these features in later videos, while we will be understanding about reports, activities, field histories, and chatters. So these are not necessary as of now. You can leave them unchecked. Then object classification. So it says when these settings are enabled, this object is classified as an enterprise application object. When these settings are disabled, this object is classified as a light application object, right? So you can choose accordingly as per the requirement. So by default, they are checked. So I'm leaving it as it is. Then deployment status. So deployment means whenever we are working in any organization, so we have various orgs. So you can understand it like this. In one org, we develop something. In one org, we test something, and then comes production. So if you are implementing something in one org, then you need to deploy it into another org. So you can choose deployment status, whether it is deployed or in development. So I'm choosing deployed, like it has completed development, and you can deploy it to the another org. Then when this setting is enabled, your users can find records of this object type when they search. So if you select this option, then your object records will be available for searching. So I'm checking it as true. Then we have some more options like object creation options. So if you want to add notes and attachment related list by default, you can select this option. If you want to launch new custom tab wizard after saving this custom object, you can choose this one. So in my another video that will be created just after this video, like how we can place objects with the help of tabs, I will be demonstrating you how we can create tabs then. But if you already know like how to create tabs, you can choose this option. And after saving this, a tab creation wizard will be available, and you can create tab for this object. So right now I am leaving these two options as unchecked, because I don't want to attach notes and attachment related list, and I don't want to create tab right now. So these are the information that comes and that you need to select while creating any object. So I'm clicking on save. So here you can see a custom object is created, and it is showing some of the details here. So singular label is student, plural label is students, object name is student, and API name is student underscore underscore C. So this API name is the unique name that you can use while developing any formula, any Apex code, or using API integration. So this will be the unique, and this is also telling that it is a custom object. So whenever you see underscore underscore C with any object name, it means that object is a custom object. If you are talking about standard object, then you will not see this underscore underscore C. So this way you can differentiate standard and custom objects. Then at right hand side, you can see the options like description, enable reports, track activities and all. So you can also edit these options later. Like you can see here, edit option is available. So if I click on edit, so it will open up that page again, and you can edit any options that you want to do. And you can click on save. Like if you want to allow this object for reports, so you can select this option and you can click on save. So this way later on we can edit the properties of an object. So you need not to worry while creating we left out these options as unselect. So what we will do like after creation, we want to select those options. So you can simply open this page for object and you can click on edit and you can change the requirement as per needed. Then you can see two options like created by and modified by. So whenever we create anything in Salesforce, it provides two options like who created and who last modified it. Then these are the information that are related to this object. So similar to object, we have two type of fields, standard fields and custom fields. So fields are the entities where we fill the actual information that unitedly create a record. So in another videos, I will demonstrate you how we can create these fields so that we can store the data. So I hope in this video, you understood how we can create objects in Salesforce. So now again, I am going to search object, clicking on objects. So here you can see this org has one object created. And earlier it was not showing any information because no custom object was there. Now, if you want to create more custom objects, you can click on this new custom object button and you can follow the same process. And here also we have edit and delete options, so you can choose accordingly. So I hope this video helped you how we can create objects in Salesforce Classic. Watch another video also so that you can learn how we can create tabs, application fields, etc. So again, this is the way you can search my YouTube channel. So thank you for watching this video.